What's up, dudes, and what's up, ladies? It's Brian here, and in this video, we are going to discuss blood sugar level. We're going to discuss what it is, why it's important, and some things you can do to keep yours in check. Let's roll.
So what is blood sugar level? Well, blood sugar level is actually exactly what it sounds like. It's the amount of sugar or glucose present in the blood. Our body gets glucose from some of the foods we eat. All right, so if we look at this little illustration here, what we have is we have the liver, have the pancreas, we have a bloodstream leading from the liver and one leading from the pancreas to this little blue area, which is going to contain cells. Now, the cells aren't going to be in just one area. This is going to be throughout the body. I've just tried to simplify this for you to get you to understand the concept. And then over here we have a blood sugar meter that we're going to keep an eye on as we go through this. So after the digestive process, the liver is going to release glucose into the bloodstream. It's going to send it to the cells to be used as energy. Now, as glucose is released into the bloodstream, blood sugar levels are going to rise, as we can see on our little meter here. This triggers the pancreas to release the hormone insulin. Now, insulin is important because it acts like a key master. It tells the cells, listen, open up, let the glucose in. When this happens, blood sugar levels are going to decrease. And this process happens many times throughout the day after we eat. Normal fasting blood sugar level, that's no food for 8 hours, is going to be between 70 and 99 milligrams per deciliter. And a normal level 2 hours after eating is going to be less than 140 milligrams per deciliter. So why is this important? Well, there are three main reasons we need to be aware of our blood sugar level. The first reason is that high blood sugar levels can lead to type 2 diabetes. And 95% of all diabetes cases in the U.S. are type 2. Type 2 diabetes is when the body doesn't use insulin properly, which is insulin resistance, or when the pancreas stops producing enough insulin. As you can see by this animation here, the bloodstream is just jammed with glucose now. Over time, high blood sugar levels can put a lot of stress on the pancreas, possibly causing it to become permanently damaged. Researchers don't fully understand why some people develop type 2 diabetes and others don't. However, there are some factors that do increase your risk. Being overweight, the more fatty tissue you have, the more resistant your cells become to insulin. Fat distribution, the more fat storage in the abdomen area has shown to increase risk. And then inactivity. Physical activity helps you control your weight. It also helps you use up glucose's energy and makes your cells more sensitive to insulin. The second reason we need to monitor our blood sugar levels is that high levels can also lead to atherosclerosis, which is hardening and narrowing of the arteries. This can block the arteries, which puts blood flow at risk, which can lead to other problems. The third reason is low blood sugar levels. Now, this is rare in non-diabetics, and it can be caused by certain medications, excessive alcohol consumption, excessive exercise, eating disorders, and from meals high in refined carbohydrates. Recommendations. So first and foremost, you're going to want to have your blood sugar level tested from time to time. You can discuss that with your doctor. You're going to want to keep yourself at a healthy body weight. You're also going to want to make sure that you're keeping active, hopefully on a daily basis, and try to limit the amount of refined or processed foods you're consuming. Try and incorporate as many whole foods in your diet as you can.
All right, folks, if you have any comments or questions, you can leave them below. If you liked or disliked the video, hit the thumbs up or the thumbs down. Till next time, I'm out. See ya.